Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. Do you like my new face? Do you want to have a new face yourself? Of course you can do this with the magic of DaVinci Resolve. So that is what this video is going to be all about, giving yourself a new face, or at least swapping a new face onto your own face. So without further ado, let's jump into DaVinci Resolve and let's get started. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve. Let's have a look at how to swap a face. And we're going to do this in the color tab, and we're going to use this clip of me right here. It's just a handheld clip, and when you're doing this swapping the face, it doesn't really matter. You don't really need to track the camera or anything because the surface tracker is really good at doing what it's supposed to do. So to make the effect better than the one you just saw in the opening, I choose not to be speaking because that's actually pretty hard to look good. Also because you're kind of taking away the celebrity's mouth or whoever's face you're putting on your own face. And that's really recognizable. So you might not even look like that person if you are speaking. So first off, I'll go up here to the effects library. I'm just going to write as you are. Here we have surface tracker. Going to add this in so it's connected after the first note. And, you know, I'll just going to zoom in a bit here. And I'll go into bounce, which is the first one here. And I'm just going to draw a shape here around my face. And, you know, it can be as good as you want it to be, but ideally we are going to do a pretty decent job here. And it's pretty easy just to rearrange the dots just by dragging. It's actually doing a pretty good job. I know that in the beta 3 you couldn't do that, but I'm in beta 6 right now, so and that works just fine now. Okay, so this is the beginning of the thing. So the thing is, I want to use my own eyes. So how do I do that? I simply do that by adding in the whole plus here. I'm just going to push that, I'm going to zoom in a bit, and now I'm just going to do a mask or a mask around my eyes, and this is what is going to stay from the original footage. So, and I'm going to add in a hole more. I'm going to add that to the other eye. And of course, if you wanted to speak or something like that, or see that mouth moving, you would do the same around the lips. Again, I want to do the best result possible, so I'm not going to do that with this footage here. Just like that. And then, you know, you can bounce around and change around if you want to just change things up just a little bit here. Just want to, something like that. Cool. So I'll go into the mesh, and here we can see all the different stuff. And I think that looks good. It should be possible to go into track and track that. I'm going to track this from wherever I am, forward and back. So I'll just push right here, and DaVinci Resolve will do its thing, and it's actually doing a pretty fast and decent job in doing so. Also, if you want to see how to do it, something similar like this, but just putting a logo on a shirt, I did do a surface tracker video, and you can see that up in the top corner. So now DaVinci Resolve will just finish up its thing, and also I'm doing these in fast quality. I could do it in better, but for the sake of the tutorial, I'm just going to do it the quality fast. So I'll go into my media pool, and I'm going to take Tom Hanks right here. I'm going to shut down my pool again. And again, I'm just going to take the green here, right here. I'm going to add this to the input, the green input in the surface tracker. And now we have this, and this looks hideous. So I'm going to go to Resolve. And again, I'll go into the overlay placement, which is right here. And then I'm going to go to the reference track here. And of course, here we could work with canvas. In this case, I think I would work with sliders because I think that's easier for me. So first off, I'm going to start to zoom in a bit here. I'm going to move around with Tom Hanks. And I think I should do some rotation here as well. The good thing about only having the eyes to worry with here is that it's a bit easier to make a face fit because you are only concentrating on the eyes. And there is a there is some trial and error in this. Or something like that, but I need to zoom it out a bit because Tom Hanks's face didn't fit totally. And then, you know, I could use the rotation here again and move it around like that. And again, rotating Tom's face. And then, you know, you could use the width as well if you want to make it fit a little bit. And also the height, something like that. And I'm going to zoom in this out a bit because Tom is losing his chin, and that's not good for Tom because he needs that. I don't know why, but he does. He really needs it. Okay, and we're just going to something like that. Yeah, and again. And you know, this can take some time because we need to finesse this a little bit. Something like that. And I'm just going to do width and reposition again, something like that. Okay, so now this looks very strange. And of course, we can play the clip and Tom's face would be here. However, we need to simply blend this in a little bit. And we're going to do that simply by going up to the operations. And I'm going to change the softness. And in fact, if I just take off the effects, it's easier to see what I'm doing. So you can see I can then blend in the softness here and expand and contrast a bit. Something like that looks good. And then playing around with the softness here. So here we have Tom's face on my face. And if we want to blend this in a little bit better, because if we can, we should. We're going to select our mat, and I'm just going to push Alt S to do another note. And in this note, I'm simply just going to go into the saturation, and I'm just going to drag down the saturation, and I'm going to zoom in a bit. And so I'm trying to match my skin color with Tom Hanks's skin color, which is a bit hard, but We'll try. So I'm just using the saturation and the color boost. I could use some tint as well and some temperature to make it a little more smooth. So something like this, a super fast clip, of course, but now we have me being Tom Hanks here. And of course, you could work more on the eyes and stuff like that, but basically, that is how we take another person's face and put it on your own. Again, a cool thing about the surface tracker, by the way, is that even though this is a handheld shot, it is actually tracking that quite well. And as you see on my lips, I did smile on the original clip a couple of times, and that's what it's doing right here. It's taking that movement into the footage. I think this is a super fun effect and a pretty fun little thing to play around with. So let me see what you come up with the surface tracker. Give me some links down in the comments below and I'll have a look at what you guys did. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.